Hello, everybody. We are going to continue this today. This is episode 3 and 4. Unfortunately, guys, I had to end off early last time. So let's see how far we haven't got much of episode 3 left. Sure.
I hoped I could find a car from there.
I think I looked earlier to find 6 episodes. So we literally got 2 more games after this and we should be all done with Alan Wake. Turn it up a little bit. Any comments, guys? Just bear with me.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger. And it was taking over everything in its path. Of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Same here. Kidding me. After all that, I just literally ripped a whole fucking new post for my bike because I'm trying to fucking sell bits to it. And the whole thing's just went, fuck you. Guess what? You no longer fucking have it. You fucking bastard. What a wank. I fucking was halfway through riding that. Here we go again, and we're fucking. I'm gonna put this next to it. You know when that really fucking hurts? can't even remember what I put them out for.
Everything in its path.
Oh, something hit me. I didn't see what it was.
Warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Okay, if I can get through this bit. Jesus. That's 24, 70, 80, 90 quid. Hello, Steve. Sorry, mate. I'm trying to multitask right now. Stuff I should have done earlier, but I didn't.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger.
Here we go.
Taking over everything in its path.
Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. Ow, ow. Okay. Manuscript. So glad I collected
teenager,
all these batteries.
Just starting to get interested in writing. Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story. Certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but
heavy duty.
The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Heavy duty? Alright, I'm guessing we're gonna need this. There's a thing over there. Box there. It's a power switch there. Okay, I'll take that. Shotgun time. All right. Fuck out of here. Wow, he didn't want to die, did he? Hey, no more manuscripts there. In the light, you can hurt. I hate these TVs.
We take the facts of our existence for granted.
Cool. Right, as we quickly watch this then. I'm going to continue my list of things that I'm going to be selling in my bike.
All too often the stars are right. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a family occasion. Journalist Alvin Durlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful. Until tonight.
Well, I'm glad you changed your minds about this. Ancient customs, local mythology. My editor loves this kind of stuff.
Well, Mr. Durlis, we don't want to feel like we're on exhibition. Handbars. But you have demonstrated the seriousness of your intent.
No, I am serious. Really, just do your thing. I'll stay out of your way and observe.
Actually, I thought you could assist us. I'm afraid we are a man short. It would provide you with an intimate perspective.
Could I really?
Of course, Mr. Durlis.
Well, I guess that's the least I... What would I have to do?
Headlights are not that much.
Here, let me show you with a kiss.
I...
Shh.
such quests always bear fruit. Night Springs.
I don't know what this Night Springs stuff is. It's fucking stupid. What the fuck is a Night Springs when you're at home, everybody? Pick him out for like 30 odd quid. Okay. Here we go again. There's a car, everybody. Oh, shit. Batteries. Fucking slowest ass gates I've ever seen in my life. Oh, that's close. I was gonna keep running without looking. Magically, the keys would be in that, wouldn't they?
I had never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw.
That's cool, because I can now rack this up to, like, 45. Oh! Okay. What episode are we on? Still on 3. Missed a page, everyone. Missed quite a few pages, actually. Well, I knew you just died. Car he had at the beginning, run out of fuel. Drive that if I want to. Sweet.
This is Pat Main, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big shot G-Man with an itchy trigger finger who could use a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass. Not necessarily in that order either. Now, folks, I know I'm not being very informative here, and I apologize for that. I really should just keep quiet, but I'm just so peeved right now, because some people just shouldn't be carrying badges. I'm just glad that our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out. And if someone I met last night is listening, let me just say, I'm sorry if my mouth got you in trouble. I'm pretty sure you're not the bad guy here. Godspeed, son. I hope you know what you're doing. Now, on a lighter note, I'll be talking to Dr. Nelson all morning. But first, a little music.
Nobody cares about me. Ain't even got a friend. Baby's gone and left me. When will my trouble?
That sounded very damn good, didn't it?
Back to KBF FM. Hope you enjoyed that tune. Now, Doc, you were talking about life and finding that special someone, that soulmate.
Well, you were talking about that. I was saying I don't buy it.
Well, see, to me, that's strange, because I always pegged you as a hopeless romantic.
You got me there, Pat. But I think love's where you look for it. And you need to do a lot of looking, sure. But the idea that there's that one special person out there for you, and if you miss that chance, it's gone forever and you're forever incomplete. I mean, that depressing? Or, heck, childish even? There's plenty of fish in the sea.
And apparently a fisherman has a fishing analogy for everything, but what you're saying, isn't that a little harsh?
Well, no. What I am saying is that your potential for finding that connection isn't limited to what's essentially a chance encounter. How's that harsh?
Yeah, well, I guess that's a nice thought, but let me say something personal here.
Okay.
Now, well, I don't disagree with you exactly, but I can't really fit that together with what I feel, what I felt for someone, because she was the one, she was. And she, I let her drift away from me. Maybe I didn't put in the work, I don't know, but, well, since then, and it was a long time ago, but since then, there hasn't been anyone, not like her. And I'm not saying I dwell on her or haven't moved on. I like my life, I'm not living in the past, but I do miss the way she completed me.
You can't argue with the heart, Pat.
I'm sorry, folks. I had kind of a scary experience last night, and let's just say it's shaken a few things loose.
Oh, wow. I can literally sell the top and bottom yolk. You'd have to know any bearings, because they'd been in there since I don't know when. No transcripts. I've probably missed most of them, to be honest. So why is it not letting me at these stairs?
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now. Thank you.
Yeah, double T. Case it goes again, because it's good at that.
I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back, or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
Serious about ignition.
I'm through being jerked around
you
by
you.
You
want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello? I'm gonna kill him.
I had to get to Mirror Peak. Maybe closer than ever before.
It's not a good sound when you hear that. Want the car back. Bitch. Let's go break this. Yoke and the buttons light. Screw you. Alright, more things are going to be thrown at me in a minute. Yeah, it's unlocked.
The only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution. There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment. I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk. The dark presence was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
The graveyard shift may cause cancer.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
Thank you.
I needed a key for the door.
Anything outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using its powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit.
The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up.
Birds.
Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain. I'd have to make my way up this mineshaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that. Thank you.
Great. Another cable car. Just great.
Thank you.
could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find.
Wait! Hey, you! Wait!
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry! Please, it's late! The boss didn't know who he was messing with! I didn't know! I swear, I didn't know!
We don't have a wife! We don't know where she is! She's probably drowned! We just said we...
Seriously telling me that Ryder just took out my deputies?
A thriller I supposedly wrote is coming true. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I was told that Alice had been kidnapped, but that was a lie.
We don't have his wife. We don't know where she is.
Her purported kidnapper was eaten up by the dark presence before it attacked me.
There you go, Alan.
Hartman,
I fell.
I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through another rough period.
What?
Right now, it's very important that you stay calm. We don't want you to have another episode. You're a patient at my clinic. Have been for a while now. The shock of your wife's death triggered a mental illness.
No, you're lying.
You're suffering from various symptoms of undifferentiated schizophrenia.
Bastard.
It's okay, Alan. Just let go.
I felt groggy. What if...
Thank you.